In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a 3D mesh surface in Rhino using contour data from an AutoCAD drawing file. Now, if you have an AutoCAD drawing file that contains the Z coordinate for your contour lines, then you can skip this step. If not, I'm going to show you how to use Equator to find contour data and download it as an AutoCAD drawing file. So first step, go to maps.equatorstudios.com. Log in or create an account. The first thing that we're going to do is search for our location. So for this tutorial, we're going to look for McFarland Road. Here we are. Now we're going to turn on the data tab to make sure that we actually have data in this location. And it looks like we do. So we're going to zoom into our project site. We're going to create a new site with this button down here at the bottom that says new site. You can move your site around. You can also choose whatever shape your site is or create a custom shape. For the purpose of this tutorial, we're going to use this shape. Okay. We will name our site. And then hit create site. There we go. So now we want to go down to the second button that says contours as a DWG. Hit the plus button. We want to select our site location, which is McFarland Road, the highest quality. And here we can choose our contour resolution. If you want smooth contours, it's 1 meter. If you want detailed, then it's 0.3 meter intervals. For the purpose of this demonstration, we're going to choose smooth and generate. And here it is, creating the contour data. Here is our contour data. Now we want to download these contours. Hit that download button. We want to download as a DWG, NAT83 for our coordinate system, and hit process. Now, if it's in a different coordinate system, you can change it to whatever coordinate system you need in that last box. Okay, and so here it is. It's been downloaded. Go to your downloads folder, and it comes in a zipped file. So we want to unzip that before bringing it into Rhino. So extract all of that. When we go into that folder, we'll see that we have a couple different drawing options or file options. We have shape files, our projection file, drawing file, DBF, a README file. So if you forget what coordinate system you're in, you can open that README file and it will tell you. So here we go, the NAD83 right here. Okay, now we go into Rhino. The easiest way to bring your file into Rhino is to just drag and drop. So drag your contour.dwg file into Rhino, open the file, hit OK. Okay. And here we go. Here are our contour lines in Rhino. Now, if we select them all, we type in extract point. All the points come through. And now we'll use the patch command. Patch. Now our defaults are usually 1, 10, 10, and 1. The U and the V are how far apart the grid lines are. Stiffness is how malleable it is around your surface. For this demonstration, I'm going to use 0.5, 100, 100, and 1. You can play around with whatever works for your surface, whatever works for your computer. Just note that the higher U and V spans you have, the more accurate it is, but also the more processing power it's going to take. So it'll take longer for your surface to be created. Press OK. And here we go. Our mesh surface has been created. So That did take quite a while for my computer. I've edited out all the time that it's taken, but it did take a couple minutes for that to be created. The next thing that we want to do is notice how there's all this extra grid created around our surface. So we're just going to create an area to trim. If we create a square, okay, select our square and use the command trim and select everything, select the grid outside of the square. And there we go. Let's maximize the perspective so we can see our grid. Okay, let's get rid of our points so we can see how well our grid matches the contour lines. So we type in the the command SELPT. So select points and then just hit delete. And then if we change our view to rendered, there we go. We can see that these did a pretty good job following the contour lines. Okay, and that is how you create a 3D mesh surface in Rhino using contour data as a DWG from Equator. Thanks for watching.